in another video, we talked about the cervical spine and how it's important to have a good healthy curve in that spinal area. What that does is it allows for the weight of the head to be evenly distributed throughout the entire spine. One of the things we see with a lot of patients is that head actually drifts forward. And when that happens, it puts a lot of stress on the muscles and the ligaments and all the other supporting structures in the neck. As a reference point, for every inch forward that head moves forward in front of the shoulders, it adds an extra 10 pounds of stress to those muscles. So if you just use 2 inches, for example, if the head's 2 inches in front of the shoulders, it adds an extra 20 pounds of stress onto the neck muscles. So combined with the weight of your head, we're now looking at muscles behaving as though your head weighs 30 pounds. So it's important that we bring the head back to being directly above the shoulders and that we implement certain things to get that accomplished. One other way to visualize it is if you look at this ball right here, this ball weighs 10 pounds, as you can see right there. It's a lot easier for me to hold this ball close to my body here because my muscles are where they need to be and they're able to do that. But if I hold the ball out here, I'm not going to be able to do it for as long because the amount of strain and stress on those muscles is much greater out in space as opposed to closer to here. So hopefully that helps drive the point home a little bit more. And if you found this information useful and you liked it, go ahead and leave a comment below and let us know if you have any questions. If you liked it, feel free to share it with your friends and family, and we'll see you next time.